up in the legs, down in the legs, down in the feet, again feet, legs, legs,
slow down.
So for those of you that were in the beginner class tonight and you were doing foxtrot, or last week, and you're doing foxtrot, we're going to practice going heel and then toe, and then heel and then toe. So one beat is the heel, next beat is the toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. So.
I'll be marching along in the big parade on St. Patrick's Day. I'll be up to me neck in shamrocks as I march along the way. I'll swing that old shillelagh as I wave to each colleen. I'll tilt me ear the better to hear the wearing of the green.
Oh, the Kelly's from Killarney, the Murphy's from Kildare,
the Hallahans and Callahans who came from County Clare.
There'll be folks from dear old Dublin all the way to County Cork.
They'll be marching in the big parade right here in old New York. Oh, the mayor will be in the big parade, strutting high and grand. And behind him will march a thousand cops who come from Ireland. Those beautiful songs of Erin, the band will play them all. We'll march along, we're singing the song, the harp will carry us all. Those sons and daughters of Erin, 100,000 strong, will be singing the songs of Ireland as they march along. Their eyes will shine with laughter, their hearts will all be gay, when the Irish all turn out to celebrate St. Patrick's Day.
We'll be marching along in the big parade on St. Patrick's Day. Not for all the tea in Dublin,
but I have to
stay away.
I'll trip to life fantastic, and how proud I'm gonna feel.
The band will play Go Whitchickle Way, a good old Irish reel.
There'll be Cooney Mulrooney and Mickey O'Dowd, cutting up capers and pleasing the crowd. Hogan and Grogan will kick up their heels, singing and dancing the jigs and the reels. The Connells, O'Donnells, and Larry O'Toole, Maloney, Mahoney, and Lefty O'Doole. Devil a man as happy as they are on St. Patrick's Day. I'll be marching along in the big parade, twinkle in me eye.
We'll be proud as a thousand peacocks, with our heads up in the sky.
I'll be there, you can bet you, when the band begins to play, and the Irish all turn out to celebrate St. Patrick's Day.
Nice. All right. Next thing we're going to do is practice going backwards. So when you're doing any of these dances, like, it's good to be able to roll from foot to foot going forward, which is what we just practiced. Now we're going to practice going backwards and rolling backwards. One of the tricks to going backwards is to stay on the ball of your foot as long as possible. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to, instead of sneaking forward on our toes, We're going to practice sneaking backwards on our toes.
Technique on how to do that, or is it just because of space?
I'm just doing it right now. Great question. So the question is, I see you pivoting, and are you doing it for space? In this case, I'm doing it for space, and we're going to talk about it a little bit more in just a second, actually. So hold that thought. I'm going to address that in just a second. So next thing is we had, of course, our tango class scheduled for today. And so tango, all the same things apply. Rolling through the feet, heel to toe when you're going forward. Rolling toe to heel when you're going backwards. Yes, but now what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to do that and keep our right side forward. So in general, when you're going line of dance in tango, your right side's forward, your left side's back. So now you're walking around ideally trying to keep that body position of the right side being forward and the left side being backwards. So let's try that going forward, kind of in a straight line first.
Hey, they want to be able to hear you over the music.
Gotcha. Roll, lift.
Macaroni Hexagon.
Say it again.
From Macaroni Hexagon.
Nice. I love the
about pivoting.
Yes.
Awesome. So pivoting, great question. One of the things that is really helpful anytime you're turning is to be able to either what we call pivot or do what we call a chenet turn. We're going to use both of those, for instance, in nightclub two-step. Yes, so pivoting is what we talk about when we talk about doing half rotations where the legs are locked forward and backwards of each other. Chenet turns are what we talk about when we talk about half rotations that are going to the side. So your legs are locked sideways relative to each other. Yes, one of the things that we want to do in order to get good at either one is find our balance point on the ball of our foot. So ideally, at this moment, you feel like your weight is kind of right over your joint where your big toe meets the rest of your foot. So that's kind of where you generally want to have your balance anytime you want to turn. Yes? Another thing that's good to do right here is to do a little bit of what I call a block check, which means all your blocks of weight, your head, your ribs, your hips, are they over that spot on your foot? Because if I'm balanced, I can turn for days, and if I'm not balanced, then it's gonna be harder for me to turn. So I'm gonna try to find that sweet spot, is what I call it, right over the ball of my foot, and then we're going to try to rotate. So I am gonna do it like you guys, so I'm here, I'm on my left foot, Yes, and then to help you rotate, go ahead and just take your left hip and twist it back a little bit. And ideally, you're still on the ball of your foot. And then twist it back again. And then twist it back. So you're just doing little baby quarter turns at a time, trying to stay on the ball of your foot as long as you can. Yes, good. And then let's do that on the other side. So again, find your weight on the ball of your foot, again, where your big toe meets the rest of your foot. Yes, block check, head over ribs, over hips, over foot. And then in this case, let's go ahead and twist that right hip back to help us turn. And right hip back. And again, you're just doing little quarter turns. Yes, now if that feels really easy for you, then try halves. And if that feels really easy for you, try three quarters. And if that feels really easy for you, try full turn. Yes, and again, you can try that on either foot. Yes, good. Okay, so let's talk about nightclub two-step underarm turns for a second. So alternating underarm turns, Tara was teaching this to you last week. Yes, she's over here. You can't see her, but she's in the background. Yes, so underarm turns. So that general step, and we do it in a million different dances, is you're gonna go to the side, you're gonna turn on that foot maybe, and then you're gonna take one more step, turn on that foot, come back, turn on that foot, and then to the side. So you can see within that little sequence, we have a lot of pivots or a lot of rotation happening on our feet. So first thing is to again find a sweet spot on this foot and then use your hip to help you turn to wherever you're gonna go. In this case, we're gonna go 90 degrees. So I'm gonna step on that foot and then again use my right hip because I'm turning the same direction, turn halfway around, and then replace my weight, find that sweet spot, turn the rest of the way around and step. Yes, so if you're comfortable with that, then the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna play around with the angles. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna step, I'm gonna turn 45 degrees and go diagonally forward and do that turn. Yes, and just so that I make you symmetric, let's also do it on the other side. So I'm gonna turn 45, I'm gonna step, find a sweet spot, step, find a sweet spot, and side. So again, I have diagonal, come back, side, diagonal, come back, side. Yes, now let's try it 90 degrees. So instead of 45, I'm gonna go 90, and 90, come back, side. Now again, turn, 90, come back, side. Again, and 90, come back, side, and 90, come back, side. Now let's say you get over rotated, yes? We're gonna go 45 degrees the other direction. Come back, side, little more turn, diagonal, come back, side. Again, this diagonal, come back, side, and now this diagonal, come back, side. Now, one of the other things that I find is really, really useful is getting used to doing this big and getting used to doing this very small. If you're a follower, you have no idea what size your leader's gonna lead it. If you're a leader, the follow might step bigger or smaller than you thought, and so sometimes you have to adjust. So for that reason, let's do big ones. So we have step, let's go on this diagonal, big step, push off, side, again, big step, push off, side, one more time, big step, push off, side, and big step, push off. Side, now same thing but 90 degrees, big step, push up, side, again, big step, push up, side, one more time, big step, push up, side, and big step, push up, side. Same thing now going on this diagonal, turn a lot, push off, big step, push off, side, turn a lot, big step, push off, slide. Hola, Tara.
What's up? We have a question.
Yeah.
It says, this is from RoboBlade. Question, how hard my back foot is pressing on the floor?
Great question. So this leg, I assume, is the one we're talking about. The answer is it depends on the dance, number one. It also depends on what look you want. So in most of the Latin dances, we want to leave that leg where it is. So I would say you're pushing with about 10% of your weight into the floor, just really squeezing the big toe along the floor when you do that. The same thing will happen when I push off here. So now I'm gonna get that same pressure here of this toe, and then I swivel, and then again, same thing will happen there. Yes? If I'm doing it with more of a club styling, or I feel like I need to be able to move my feet more for whatever reason, I could pick up that back leg to help me with that. Awesome. Yes, let's do one more time, big going this way. So we have sigh and push up, step and sigh, and again, push up, step and sigh. Now let's do the opposite of that. Let's go really, really tiny. So I'm going to turn and I'm going to basically step just right in front of my other foot. Step and side. Same thing, just right in front of my other foot. Side, again, baby step. Side, again, baby step. Side, let's go 90. And baby step. Side, baby step. Side, again. Small steps. Yes, and then same thing going this way, but again with small steps. So now I turn a lot, but my step is very small. Turn a lot, but my step is very small. Being able to be balanced and modify the size of your steps is really what's going to allow you to lead and follow well, because you can take whatever circumstance you find yourself in and adjust for it. Much like we are right now in our everyday lives. Yay. Yes? So that's our nightclub two-step general alternating underarm turns. Now, moving on. Yeah, sorry, go ahead.
RoboBlade says he wonders how much of that is balance strength or core strength.
That's a good question.
And he and Solo Gardner are both complimenting you on your grace, and RoboBlade really wants a medal or a star or chocolate for his great questions.
That's awesome. I think you should get all those things, and next time we can actually talk to you live, maybe that'll happen. To find my balance, it requires a couple things. Number one, again, my blocks in general need to be lined up. It's not that I can't be not lined up, it's just a lot harder if I'm not. So it's a little bit easier if my blocks are lined up. Number two, using the ground. So sometimes we talk about the idea here that the ground is your first partner and your human partner is your second partner. So the idea that you're really pushing into the ground with the ball of your foot and using that to gain some power and some stability, yes. And then just to keep my blocks lined up, to keep everything kind of working, to keep myself balanced, I do have to have usually a tone throughout my whole body. So not just my legs, but my glutes are working, my abs are working a little bit. To keep my blocks lined up, I've got some shoulder tone. Yes, all those things working together to help me do that. Good question. Thank you for your questions. We appreciate it. Awesome. Good? Yes, mm-hmm. On that? Cool. Okay, so continuing on with nightclub two-step, the level 5 class has been working on some interesting patterns throughout this. And if you're not in the level 5 class, that's not a problem, because the stuff that I'm going to talk about now is pretty generic in terms of nightclub two-step form, but also again helps with a million other things. So one of the things that's kind of fun that we do in ballroom styled nightclub two-step is that sometimes we apply what's called a float, which means that at the end of, for instance, a side cross side, I actually rise up at the end of that step and then what we call hover down out of it. So again, I'm going side cross, I come into a bent leg, rise up on that leg, rotate on that leg, and then from here I'm going to go toe heel to come out of it and then cross side. So again, I have side cross and float, and side cross side, or side cross and float, and hover cross side. Yes? So this is a fun thing to incorporate into your general side cross sides. It's something that you tend to see ballroom dancers do a little bit more because honestly we tend to rise and fall in our feet more, so it's something we tend to be a little bit more used to. There's another style of nightclub two-step that's very flat. You'll notice that more, for instance, at West Coast Swing conventions. So they're all good, they're all lovely. This is just another option for you. So adding the float into your side cross sides is really fun. Next thing is just doing, again, pivots. So pivots are something that we use in all the dances, not just nightclub two-step. So how I go into my front leg, it depends on what style of dance I'm doing. If I'm doing a ballroom dance and I'm low, it's going to be heel toe. If I'm doing a Latin or a club dance, it's going to tend to just be the ball of the foot straight. Yes, I'm going to keep my legs locked in this configuration so that this leg is behind this leg. And then I'm again going to turn on the ball of that foot. In order to turn on the ball of that foot and feel balance, I like to twist my hip back because it tends to allow me to be a little bit more stable versus throwing my arms or my head. I find that tends to take me off my foot a little bit. So twisting the hip to help me turn, I find really useful. Then I'm going to go into the ball of the back foot. Doesn't matter whether you're doing ballroom or Latin, you're going to just stay on the ball of that foot. Again, keep the legs locked. And then again, twist that hip. So I'm going to go step and twist and step and twist and step and twist, and I'm out of room, step and twist. Yes, and in this case, I was doing it with my left foot forward and turning to the left. Again, check and make sure you're on your sweet spot, especially on all back steps. Yes, I can also do it with my right foot forward, so it's good to be able to do it in both directions. So again, heel ball or just ball only, depending on the dance you're practicing. In nightclub two-step, it would be ball only. And then coming back onto the ball of the foot and twisting. So when I'm turning to the right, I'm going to twist my right hip back to help me create the rotation. And when I'm going left, I'm going to twist my left hip back to help me create the rotation. Yes, so for instance, sometimes we get led into turns. In the case of the level 5 nightclub two-step class, we went quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. So we had a lot of pivot turns there where there were forward and back legs going on. The other way that we can do that is, before I leave pivots, a great thing to practice once you're comfortable with that is to practice again, like we did with the alternating underarm turns, to practice size of step. So this is pretty fun, practicing big, big pivoting steps. Yes, and getting comfortable pushing off and finding your sweet spot on big steps. But it's actually just as useful, if not frankly almost more useful, to also be able to do it really, really tiny. Because sometimes you'd have to turn very quickly in not very much space. So that becomes very, very useful as well. So practicing in both directions, both sizes. So let's do that for a second. So let's go big pivot, small pivot, small pivot. Yes? I'm gonna back up. Hopefully you have enough room in your kitchen. And big pivot, big pivot, small pivot, small pivot. Yes? So that was me going forward with my left foot. Whichever foot you just went with, go with the other one this time. So we have, again, big pivot, and then small pivot. And again, big pivot, small pivot, small pivot. Yep, and that way you can do whatever you need to do given what is occurring in the moment. Next type of turn is a chaîne turn. So with the chaîne turns, again, these are sideways based. We can do what we call an open chaîne, which means I have my first step is open to the side, my second step is also open to the side, and then usually on your third step you land. So sometimes you'll hear this called a three-step turn. One, two, three. One, two, three. Yes? And the other way we can do it is we can do it as what's called a closed chaîne, which means that I go open on the first step, meaning my legs are apart, closed on the second step, and then again open on the third, for instance. Yes, so again, the trick to this is the same as the trick to the others, which is just finding your balance point, using the ground, keeping the blocks lined up, find that space, and then use your hip to twist to cause rotation. And then I'm gonna switch to the ball of this foot and use the same hip to rotate because I'm rotating the same direction the whole time. And then sidestep. Yeah, so same thing. So I'm gonna step on it. I'm gonna use this hip to twist back. I'm gonna find my balance on my new foot. Still use the same hip to twist back and then step. Yes, so if we do that again, and you can practice open or close, whatever floats your boat. We have balance, twist, and land, and balance, twist, and land. Yes? Now, just like we did with the pivots, it's good to be able to do this big or small. So I can go big, so let's do that both directions. So I have big, land, big, land. Big, land, big, land. And now let's do the opposite of that. Let's do it as small as possible. So step number one, step number two, land. Awesome. Same thing, right next to my foot, land. Yeah, so I can go as tiny as I want. Or I can go as big as I want. Whatever I want to do. Yay. So far, so good. So that is, again, practicing your rotations, both chaîne turns, which is, again, sideways, pivot turns, which is forward and back. Yes. And then we also practiced earlier spot turns, also called walk-around turns, is what we're also doing in that clip two-step. Yes, I have one more exercise for the leaders that were in my nightclub two-step class. They'll understand. For the rest of you, this is just gonna look like a weird martial arts move. Yes, so we're gonna go arms apart, right arm comes in, left arm to there. Yes, so again, boom, boom, split, boom, boom, split. Yes? So that's the way to practice the arms that set up the move that we did last week. And we talked about the idea that just having that in muscle memory makes it infinitely easier when you're actually trying to lead the move that we were doing. Another thing that we're going to go into now, segueing into the quick step class, and for those of you that are freaking out right now, quick step, don't worry, it's okay. We're just gonna be talking about some very general ballroom things for a second, so not to worry if you don't know quick step yet or you're not as comfortable with quick step. It'll be fine, we're just gonna do some exercises. First exercise is the idea that you're just trying to put your head in the opposite direction from your foot. So if I'm stretching, then my head is going this way and my leg is going the opposite direction. Yes, so I'm going to vertical and then stretch. And vertical and stretch.
Christina, we had some buffering issue, and they want to see the
martial arts
move again from a different angle.
Oh, sure. Yeah, no problem. So, martial arts move from a different angle, deciding which angle is best. Let me try this way first. So, I'm facing this way. My left hand, my right hand, yes. I'm going to split them. I'm going to come in with my right. And now I'm going to circle my left around and grab my right upper arm. Yes, so again, out, right arm comes in, then go left, right. So out, right arm, left, right to here. Yes, and that'll help us with the move that we were doing last week. Different angle, just in case it's helpful, here. Right, left, right. Again, here, right, left, right. Yes? Okay. So, ballroom, going back to ballroom. So again, nice and up. It's not a bad idea at this time to just do one of those, come up with everything, and then just try to stay there as much as you can. Yes? And then again, we're going to stretch the head away from the foot. And let's do it on the other side, because sometimes we need the other side as well. So we have stretching head to the left, stretching head to the right, stretching head to the left, stretching head to the right. Now, one of the things about the nightclub two-step level 5 class is when the leader goes for the hip catch, this can have a different look to it, so it can have a little bit more of a ballroomy look. We talked about the leader potentially doing this stretch with the right hand to catch the hip. So if the leader did that, then instead of taking myself to the left, I'm going to stay vertical, but I'm going to twist my right side forward and my left side back. So I'm going twist, 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 twist. And again, just so we're symmetric, we're going to do it the other way. So now I'm going to go twist, 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 and twist. So what that would look like in the step if you were doing it is you would have gone quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, if you wanted to do that. As a leader when you're doing the hip catch. The follow is doing that chaîne turn we talked about. And because the leader rotates, the follow will also rotate. So the follow is going to end up going here and here and here potentially. And here and here and here. So we're kind of practicing a little bit of a ballroom styling a little bit in the nightclub two-step. So then, going back, getting to our stretch position, we want to make sure that whichever side our head is on, that side is still lifted. So I'm going to step together, make sure this side's lifted. Step together, make sure this side's lifted. Lift. Lift. Yes? So the first thing that we did in nightclub two-step is what's called a natural turn. That's just a fancy way of saying a 3/8 turn to the right. So that's something that we do in waltz, we do it in foxtrot, we do it in Viennese waltz, we do it in quickstep, we do it in all the dances. So again, if you don't know quickstep yet, this will still be very useful for you. So the follows are going to practice this, stepping back on the left foot and again hitting that line. That's ideally what your first step and a half feels like. So step and stretch, and then you're just waiting for the leader to pull you over and bring you up. Yes, but your stretching is pretty much done pretty early. So again, step and stretch, and then over and up. And again, one more time. And step and stretch and over and up. Yes? If you're a follow, go ahead and keep practicing that. If you're a leader, what we're doing is we're going to step forward with our right foot. Hold on, I'm deciding which is the best angle for you. Yeah, go ahead, Tara.
Twist, twist, twist. Are we extending? What exactly when twisting? Are we extending?
You are, when you're twisting.
It means how far?
Yeah, you're pretty much until just we twisting feel what? Your hips. You're just twisting basically until your hips don't want to twist anymore. That's a great question. So how much do I twist? You're going to twist until basically you feel like your hips won't go any farther, or it'll be really hard to do that. That would be the safest way to do it for right now. Awesome. Good question. So then for leaders, hold on, I have to think about the leaders a bit. Yes, I need to go here. So if you're a leader, follows, you're still doing what you were doing. Yes, if you're a leader and you're going into a right turn, the difficulty is when we start to go up like this, it tends to take our head into our follow space. So you may have heard the idea that the follow is over here, you're over here, and we have to maintain our sides. So the follow's on this side, the leader's on this side. When we stretch up this way, there's a tendency for the leader's head to come into the follow side. So to avoid that, something that's really lovely to practice when you're doing right turns leaders is you're gonna go forward with your right foot, and then I actually want you to stretch this way. So you're gonna try to leave your head looking where it was going and then shape your body but not really do anything with your head. You'll have a slight change at the end from the head looking this way to looking that way, but that's about it. And that'll help you keep your head on your side. So again, leaders, you're gonna step forward with the right foot. You're gonna get onto the ball of the foot. Again, here's that balance point that we've been working on today. You're gonna stretch up this way. Yes, and then you're gonna stay there, come up, and at the last second, just look towards, in this case, I'm looking at the shamrock, fake shamrock, yes? So again, I have step, find your balance point, reach out, go onto that leg, and come up. And it's just as you're coming up, the head goes from here to there. And that's a really lovely way, again, of keeping a counterweight, which makes it so that both partners can rotate around each other a little bit easier. Yes, so if we do that again, leaders, step, reach, look for it, come up. Yes, and again, step, reach, look for it, come up. Yes, follows, I haven't forgotten you. Follows, again, you're going step, stretch, and then over and up. You're going step, stretch, over and up. Cool, so that's the beginning of a right turn. And again, you can do that in any of the ballroom dances, so this will help you in everything. Yes, next thing I want to, I think, end with for today is just that pivot idea. If you feel like you have that pivot really, really well, then my challenge for you is to get onto the ball of the foot going backwards and turn all the way around. Yes? So the thing that we were doing in invitational quick step is we were going into a natural turn, and then there's what's called a natural pivot at the end of that. And so we have to be able to turn halfway, be really balanced because of what's next. So your challenge for today is to get onto the ball of your foot and see how far you can get around. Ideally, you're gonna try to get all the way around. And then try to do that just so that you're symmetric on both feet. Yes, I hope you had a good time today. I hope you learned something. And thank you for joining us. Thanks for being here and delighting in the day. And let me know if you have any other questions. Thank you.
Cool. Thank you, everybody. Rubber Blade left like 2 minutes ago, so okay. Our biggest question asker isn't there. Does anyone else have any questions? about anything, not necessarily just the class, before we wrap up? We have about a 4 second lag, so. Jan Sutterfield says, 360-degree pivots, wow, nice challenge. This online class is very cool. Thank you so much.
Hey, Jan. Hope you're feeling well.
Macaroni Hexagon says, yay.
Yay. Thanks for all your questions. Awesome.
Cool. And I think Grace Cheng says, thanks. So,
all right. Grace.
Awesome.
Hope your hips bend.
Thank you, everybody. We'll let you know when we're going to do this again soon. And yeah, if you follow and then hit the little thing additionally that says to give you notifications, then it will email notify you when we're going live. And we'll do our best to post on Facebook as far ahead of time as possible. Give you a heads up. Especially better now that we have this set up. And I will do what I can to try to figure out the drop frame and fix that. And this video will go to YouTube very soon. So thank you, everybody. And we will see you soon.